everyone. I know it's been a very long time since I have made a video. I've had a lot going on last year. Those of you who follow me on Twitter will know what's been going on in regards to my transition. And YouTube hasn't been a priority for me. But I've decided to make this video because tomorrow, which is Sunday, May the 3rd, it's going to be my 3-year transgender anniversary, and so I really wanted to do something special to celebrate. So I thought, why not do a Q&A where you can ask me questions about anything you want to know. So this video might be a bit long, I really apologise for that. So either put it on in the background on a different tab, or just get a drink or some food and just sit back and relax, because it's going to be a talking video today. I didn't want anything like fancy editing and stuff like that. I can't be bothered for that. Okay, so let's just get into this Q&A to save a bit of time. So the first, I asked people questions from MSP and on Twitter, so there's going to be a mix of people. So the first question is from Grande Productions, who is actually my bestie, and they said, when did you figure out you wanted to be trans? So I always knew I was not trans, but I knew I was different at the age of like 6 and 7. I always picked girl characters on the game, on like games I played, and I always used to wear towels over my head and pretend it was long hair at such a young age. And at that point, I didn't know that I was trans, because obviously I didn't even know what trans meant. I just knew that I was very different to other people and I didn't really fit in much. However, when I sort of became a teenager, like 13, 14-ish, and I started to go through like male puberty, I started to feel really uncomfortable with myself, and it took a while to really figure out what was making me uncomfortable. And then I realised that I wasn't comfortable with my own skin. I didn't like the way people were addressing me as a male, and that's when I figured out I want to be a girl. And then I found out what trans meant, and that is how I figured out that that is me. The next question is from Satan MSP on Twitter, and it says, was it hard coming to terms with the fact that you are trans? So I don't particularly know what you mean by coming to terms with the fact that you are trans, but I will say that the whole point of my transition is to become as much as a woman as I possibly can, and I feel like it's hard having to get over the fact that you are different. You aren't a biological female, and that it's gonna take time to really be who you are comfortable with. And I just feel like it took a while to really come to the fact that I am different from biological women, and that no matter how many surgeries I go through, or how many procedures I have, or how many hormones I take, I'm always going to be a trans woman. So I feel like I had to come to terms and accept that. But to be honest, I'm happy that I am, because, you know, I have a different story to tell, and I feel like that's what makes me unique. And I'm happy that I am able to tell that story. Next question is from Miss Pink on Twitter, who says, what's the one thing you love most about being trans and the one thing you dislike? So the one thing I love most about being trans is that I'm able to tell my story, and I'm able to inspire so many people. And I think that is what's really benefited me, because I have being able to find happiness in being able to inspire people. And I just feel like that is what I love most about being trans, is just, being able to make these art books at MSP and being told by loads of people that I've helped them come out. I've been an inspiration to them. I feel like that's the most rewarding thing about being trans, and I love that aspect so much. The one thing I dislike about being trans is people who just don't get it and just don't understand. A lot of people make a lot of assumptions about trans people. They think they know everything about them, and I just feel like there is so much to being trans, and people just don't see it. Like, they think it's a choice. They just think all these crazy things, and I feel like you can't really judge until you've been through something. So that's the one thing I hate, is people thinking they know everything and they just don't. So definitely people who don't understand and are just too uneducated and just make up assumptions and hate comments and stuff like that. I think that's the one thing that really pushes me over the edge and really annoys me. Next question says, were your friends supportive about your transition from the start? Yes. So actually, my friends knew that I was different before I even came out. So it wasn't even a shock to them. They were like, oh, we knew you were more feminine. We knew. We suspected it, And that was like, oh, really? Because most of my friends are girls anyway. So they pretty much knew that I was like them. And they were so supportive about it. As soon as I came out, a few days later, I had girls wanting to do my makeup on the school field at lunchtime, which I was very new to that stuff, but I was just so happy that they were not rejecting me and they were treating me as their own. So, yes, my friends were very supportive. However, I did have some people who weren't my friends, but they just didn't really accept it. But yeah, my friends were very supportive, and I still speak to some of them today. I do hairdressing and I did beauty, so I bring them in for like treatments, for like assessments, and we just talk and talk and talk and talk. And honestly, I have such a good friendship with them now. I feel like we've gotten stronger because of it, and yeah, they were very supportive. Question five. This one, I tried to keep it very PG, but this just, I felt like I needed to address. So, do you have periods? So, no, I do not get periods. I never will get periods. However, I do feel like I get the mood side of it. Like, a certain time of month, I'll get more moody. I will get just very diff. I can notice a difference. So I feel like I get the mood side of it, but I do not bleed down below, and I will never have that even after my surgery. So no. Question six: what is your dead name? So for those who don't know, this basically means my boy name. To be honest, I don't feel comfortable with speaking about much boy stuff. I'm trying to move on from that part in my life that was very depressing for me and caused a lot of distress. And so I feel like my close friends on Twitter and online and in real life know my boy name, and they don't care. They didn't care about it. But I just don't want to announce it because I want people to see me as a woman and judge me as a woman, and I don't want to reveal too much about my boy self that people see me as a boy, if that makes any sense at all. So I don't want to say that, but if you know, then you know. 7, how do you deal with people who are against trans? So I've had loads of people in the past say, you know, this is a choice, why did you do it, you brought it upon yourself, you did this, you'll never be a girl, you'll always be a boy, you'll do this, blah 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 blah. Like, honestly, I used to really not be able to deal with it at the start. I used to go home, I used to cry, I can't lie about that. But I feel like the more confident you get, the more you are able to deal with it. Especially with me, I was able to actually see that I had so much support that it actually outweighed the negative comments so much. And I just thought, why should I let someone who doesn't know anything about me, like, think that they can just bring me down like that? So if they are against trans, you know, they're entitled to their own opinion. Not saying it's the right opinion, but I just ignore them, get on with my life, you know. They're not going to stop me, nothing's going to stop me. So yeah, just brush it off and move on. 8, how old are you? I am 17 right now, however I am 18 on May the 31st, which, completely crazy, I'm terrified. But yeah, you know, we got to get old at some point. 9, but why? Okay, so I have loads of people asking why I transition. I transitioned because as a boy, I was very depressed. I was very down about people calling me a boy. I was very down at seeing myself as a boy, at dressing as a boy. And it made me want to do something bad to myself that was going to scar my family. I don't want to. I'm trying to keep this PG. But I think you probably know what I mean. Yeah, I was that low at that point, and I found happiness in being a girl and being called a girl. And I feel like my relatives have always told me to follow whatever makes you happy and to do whatever makes you happy. And I think if this makes me happy, then why should anyone have an issue with it? You know, it's none of anyone's business. It's simply what I am doing to keep myself alive and just make sure I'm giving myself the best possible life. So that is why. 10, will you get surgery? I haven't had anything medical done yet. My next step is to actually get hormones. I'm waiting for them. And then I'm going to see how that changes my body. In terms of bottom surgery, that surgery is really risky. And I've been thinking a lot about getting it. But at this moment in time, you know, I'm single, I'm not in a relationship, I'm not in a long-term relationship. I just don't feel like it's something that I truly need to do, especially with the risk that it brings. So perhaps in the future, yes, I will get it. But right now, I'm more concerned about getting hormones and starting those. So it's sort of not on my list right now, but probably will be in the future. Number 11, do you date girls or guys? So I normally go for guys. However, I do not mind. I would not mind dating a girl. So I guess both. Question 12, how did it feel to go out for the first time as a girl? So the first time I went out as a girl was actually in school. I remember I came to school in a full face of makeup, just normal, just walked into class like it was a normal thing. And my teacher actually shouted at me. Funnily enough, she thought that a girl had bullied me into doing this, had, you know, forced makeup onto me. And I was like, no, that's not the issue. And I had to explain to her that I'm trans, it's okay. And she was fine with it after that. But that was a very weird experience. But I think, how did it feel? I was actually really happy that I was able to go out wearing makeup. I felt very much like myself, and I had no issues with it, you know? So it felt good. Okay, next question, which I believe is question 14 or 13, 13. So this isn't really a question, but it's something that I want to respond to. So this person said, "I want to be a boy, but I wouldn't go that far. Accept your gender." So I feel like that is totally your opinion. You know, if you wouldn't go that far, that's you. You know, I was so down and depressed that I couldn't accept my gender, no matter how hard I tried. I actually tried to do it, but I just feel like with trans, you cannot like accept something that is making you want to do something. You know, I'm trying to keep this PG. So it's really hard. Like, you can't just say accept your gender, you know. I just feel like that is such a bad thing to say, and that is so damaging to do, and it will affect your mental health as well. So if you wouldn't change your gender, that is on you. Okay, well done, congratulations. But I had to do this to make myself happy, and I feel like that is none of your concern at all, whether I decide to do it or not, which I did do it. But you know, I just feel like I had to do this to really be able to see myself in the future, and you know, that's none of your business whether I do that or not. So, shoo. Next question. Have you ever doubted being trans? So, yes. Not as much really as I thought I would. But there has come times where I'm like, you know, I'm sick of this. I'm sick of trying so hard and not getting anywhere. I'm sick of just not being like, I wake up some days and I still feel upset, I still feel uncomfortable. And I feel like that's when you start to doubt, like, you know, is this really the right thing for me? And I have said to myself, like, oh, maybe I should just go back to a boy and just suck it up and accept it. But I really can't. And I feel like that's what people really don't understand. But I have not let anyone else doubt me being trans. You know, I've not let hate comments make me go, oh, I'm gonna stop now. You know, I think the doubt is coming from my own personal feelings. So yes, I have doubted it in the past. Question 16, is it something you will regret? So I've been on this for 3 years now. I don't think I ever will regret it. You know, I was so sad back then as a boy for all those many years. I was so sad being forced to be presented as a boy in the outside world. It was causing so much harm to my mind, and so I don't think I would go back to it. And I am much happier now. I can see myself much happier. And I know that going in this direction is something that is better than stepping all the way back. So, I don't think I ever will regret it, no. Next question. Do you wear a wig or have you grown your hair out? I used to wear a wig back when my hair was short. However, my hair is now shoulder length, so I'm much more confident, and I literally go out with just my normal hair. However, I do like to wear a wig sometimes for photos and just, you know, spice it up a bit, because, you know, I feel like that's what a normal woman would do anyway. I know normal women wear wigs as well. So I just feel like, yeah, I feel like I'm a very like dressy up person. So wearing wigs does make me feel happy. And I only really use it for photos now. That's literally it. Next question. Which toilets do you use? This is a very good question. So I actually use the women's toilets. Now I know I'm probably going to get a lot of like controversy about this, but you know, with how I look right now, you know, long hair, makeup, girls' clothes, I feel like if I was to go into the men's bathroom, I would get more looks and stares, and that would damage me. And when I go into the women's bathroom, all I do is just go in, do my stuff, wash my hands and go out. And I don't feel like I get any looks or any stares because, you know, I put effort to look like a woman. You know, I shave, I wear makeup, I have long hair, I wear girls' clothes. And I'm not very tall. And I just feel like it is better for me to go into the women's. However, if there is like a disabled toilet, I will go in that instead, because disabled toilets are one cubicle and it's unisex. So I will go into the disabled toilets to just save myself some, like, I don't even know. I'll just go into the disabled toilets just to save myself some commotion. And yeah, next question is a very good one, which I'm gonna have a bit of debate here. So this question says, what do you think about the law stating anyone under 18 can medically transition? So I don't know what country you are in, but I don't think every country has that law, but I think it's a very good law. Now I'm probably gonna get some hate for this, but I feel like there's been a lot of cases of parents actually forcing their kids into gender transition, and I feel like that is something that is so harmful to the kids. You know, some stuff that are involved in gender transitioning are almost literally irreversible. You cannot go back once you've had them done. And I just feel like a 12-year-old kid does not understand, just cannot understand that. You know, it's not a game, it's not something to do for fun, it's serious, it's real life. And when I went to the gender clinic, I was given a questionnaire sheet that I had to fill in, and it was for 12 to 18-year-olds. So keep in mind that me, a 17-year-old, was answering the same questions as a 12-year-old was answering. And there was questions like, you know, like general questions like, do you feel uncomfortable with your gender? Do you feel different? But there was one question that said, would you change your genitals? Now, I feel like asking that to a 12-year-old who doesn't even know and understand the function of what's down there really should be making up decisions if they want to change it or not. I agree that we should be offering support like therapy and just help, but I don't think medical transition is something that a 12-year-old is really ready to do. You know, I'm 17, I'm almost 18, I'm scared. You know, I am scared to get surgery, and I just feel like a 12-year-old is so much unprepared, and it's actually quite sad that, you know, that this is happening. Sorry about that, I got a really dry throat. I actually don't have a drink in here. I should have brought a drink up here, but I got a really dry throat, so excuse me. Next question. Who has helped you on your transition? All of you guys. Literally. I cannot like express how much of an impact all of you have had on my life. You know, posting these art books and just you guys accepting me as a woman and treating me as a woman has honestly given me the confidence to do anything in my life. And I feel like I owe it all to every single one of you, because you have helped me the most. And I know a lot of you say, "Oh my God, Lauren, you're so inspiring. You've inspired me so much." I feel like, no, you have inspired me, which has then made me inspire you back. We inspire each other. And I just feel like you have helped me more than you imagine. And I will never ever be able to express how thankful I am for that. You've literally given me a life to look forward to, and so thank you from the bottom of my heart for that. Next question: at school, where do you get change of p? So I actually don't go to school anymore. I go to college where I do hairdressing, but at school before I transitioned, I would be in the boys' changing rooms, and I was very uncomfortable with that. Before I even came out, I was in the boys' changing rooms. And I would like wait until everyone has changed and gone until I then got changed, because I just felt so uncomfortable getting undressed in a room of these boys. So, but as soon as I came out as trans, I told the teacher and she let me get changed in the disabled toilets. So that was much more safer for me and I felt much more comfortable. So I was on my own. However, I still had to do boys' PE, which led to me skiving a lot of lessons. I got caught for it, and they said, "You know, why are you skipping lessons?" And I said, "You know, I don't feel comfortable being with the boys." And, you know, they were so nice about it, and they actually made me do extra maths and English lessons instead of doing PE, which I preferred so much. So yeah, that is what happened. Next question: do you get offended when someone calls you a boy? I think when someone calls me a boy, I won't flip out. I won't, you know, have like a huge, massive like fit at them. I won't shout at them, but it definitely makes me feel sad inside, but I don't show it. I just sort of brush it off, don't let it get to me. But I would feel offended inside, but I probably wouldn't show it. Like, I wouldn't go to the lengths of causing a fight because of it, because it's just not worth it at all. And this is the last question of that I picked out, because you know this is almost a 30-minute video already. So last question: do you feel like society is more accepting now? So yes, if you look back like 10 years ago, being transgender was literally, people thought it was boys dressing up in girls' clothes and doing like prostitution and stuff like that. And there wasn't much known about it in terms of medical transition and actually wanting to live a life. And so I feel like after social media came into play and YouTube came and we started to see more influencers talking about their story, I feel like that definitely opened up the doors to what being trans actually meant, and it allowed people to accept that more. And I feel like we are also educating ourselves more in it, like schools, we're becoming aware of just LGBT in general, and I feel like that is such a good thing. You know, there has been laws passed like stating discrimination in the workplace that protects us transgender people from that, and I feel like that has also allowed society to include us as one of them. And yeah, I do feel very strongly that it has been more accepting the past few years. And I think that is all down to more exposure of what transgender actually is. And I feel like that is such a good and positive thing and a huge step forward. And I think there's still so much that we need to do, especially in like other countries like Saudi Arabia, where you go there, and if you're even suspected of being trans, they will throw you in prison or throw stones at you to death. And I just feel like there is so much more that needs to be done so we can be accepted. But it has changed for the better. And I feel like we're only going to keep on going up from here. And, you know, I want to be a part of that change. I want to be someone who is changing people's minds and inspiring people. And I feel like that's what I have done on MSP the past few years. So, anyway, that is all of the questions that I feel like I have time to answer. This is a very long video. I'm so sorry for that. I hope you all enjoyed anyway. If you do want me to come back and do any more videos, please do leave them down below because I'd love some suggestions. Also, if you have any questions that you want to ask that you didn't get to ask, then leave them down below and I will answer them in the comments. But yeah, thank you. Thank you so much if you had watched this far. I know it's been a very long and boring video. I'm so sorry for that. But thank you for sticking around and thank you for tuning in. And maybe I'll see you again soon. Bye.